हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आप क्लास ट्वेल्थ इंग्लिश मीडियम आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू टीच यू थ्रू दिस इम्पोर्टेंट चैप्टर अ प्रेयर फॉर माई डॉटर. ए प्रेयर फॉर माई डॉटर इज रिटन बाई विलियम बटलर ईट्स. ओके, एंड इन दिस पोएम द पोएट इज एगोनी. एगोनी मीन्स वेरी सैड, ग्लूम्ड, unhappy. For what he is very unhappy? He is unhappy due to the bird bar one that happened all around the bird. I think now you understood why he is gloomy. And my dear student, I would like to tell you, we are very caring to our family, for our family. We are very caring. We take care of our family and all the way. We look their future, whether the future of our ward, our child is secure or not. In this way, William Butler Yeats was also very worried, thinking that whether the future of my child is, my daughter is secure or not, because everywhere he was looking that the whole world is involved in the bar. Everywhere can be seen bloodshed and many other things happening. Everywhere there was anarchy. Anarchy means tyranny, means no one was giving due respect to anyone. In this way, through his unhappiness of heart inside, he started writing a poem, and in this way to secure his daughter who is newly born baby. For her he starts composing a poem called A Prayer for My Daughter. So you see there, A Prayer for My Daughter by William Butler Yeats opens with the image of the newborn child sleeping in a cradle. A storm of bar during the bird bar one, raging with great fury outside. Great fury outside means everywhere you see the people were engaged in fighting with each other, or with one country was fighting or trying to defeat another country. And a great gloom is on its mind, because everyone in this world beloved human being and other creatures. In the same way, the poet also loves each and every people of his neighborhood. But the bar opened and all were in mood of the bar fighting, and due to this everywhere you can see hurdles and anarchy took place in place of peace and tranquility. Child, so in the house of William Butler Yeats, there a newborn baby took birth, and for his generation, for newborn baby, he wants to protect her. For that, he composed a poem called A Prayer for My Daughter. In this first stanza, he describes, written that A Prayer for My Daughter, William Butler Yeats, opened with the image of the newborn child sleeping in a cradle. A storm is raging with great fury outside his residence. A great gloom is on its mind and is consumed with anxiety as to how to protect his child from the tide of hard times ahead. Means the situation was very difficult and complex to overcome from it. However, the poet keeps walking and praying for the young child, and as he does so, he is in a state of reverie. Reverie means imagination. Whether I will get my daughter on the cradle same sleeping or not. It was the daydream of Mr. William Butler Yeats. Reverie means image. Daydream. He feels a kind of gloom and worry about the future of his daughter. As I earlier mentioned to you. Now, he says, as I walk and pray for my younger daughter, I imagine in a state of excitement and reverie that the future years of violence and bloodshed and frenzy have already happened. So, in this way, come and that the seem to come dancing to accompaniment of a drum which is beating frantically, these great things had happened. Okay, so in this way, in the first stanza, you will see in the first stanza, W.B. Yeats start explaining it want his daughter to possess some qualities so that she can face the future years. Means he want his baby make strong and full of strength that can be able to fight and protect herself from any agony of the future independently and with confidence. We raise confidence in our child so that they could stand and they could fight against any difficulties in their life. It happens same to our dear students. Don't forget, you have to fight, stand and awake and go till your goal is achieved, said by Vivekananda. In the same way, W.B. Yeats want from each and every child that he or she should be able to fight against any difficulties in their life. It wants his daughter to possess some qualities. In the same way, Yeats also wants some qualities so that she can face the future years independently and with confidence. Okay. It says, let her be given beauty, but a more important thing is that her beauty should not be of kind which may either make the proud of her beauty or distract a stranger's mind and eyes. Those whose beauty is, means what kind of beauty he wants to explain? He does not want to explain the beauty of physical appearance. He wants the beauty that is applicable to fight against any difficulties in her life. There are two kind of beauties. First, physical appearance. Second, the beauty of protecting ourselves from the difficulties and complex situation. So in this way, second thing he wants from her daughter. Now you see, those whose beauty is capable of making them proud consider beauty an end in itself. The result is that pride leads to their losing natural kindness, in some cases of that heart, revealing intimacy which helps them to make the right choice in life. Means he wants from her ward, from her child, to be proud, to feel confident, be confident and fight against any circumstances, any situation, any difficulties. And in this intimacy of revealing, which helps them to make the right choice in life. Means if you are confident, you can make such an important notice yourself that you are able to stand yourself without the help of any other. Right choice in life. And if you are able to make decision, means you are able to make your choice in the life. Being the able to make the right choice in life is very important thing. But those who have excessive beauty are unable to do so. Means whenever you start thinking about your physical appearance, physical beauty, you are unable to go towards the protection that you should have taken. But before this, if you think about the beauty of inner choice, means confidence, persistence and confidence, then you are able to show your beauty as an external part of your life, and your confidence raise encourage you to do or to face some important situations on behalf of your confidence and persistence, and you are able to take your decision there. That is the internal beauty of your body. And external beauty of your body means whenever you are looking smart, skilled, and very means you start trying to make up yourself for the physical appearance to attract others' mind and thought, it means you are very weak. So make sure that you are trying to make your all the applicable beauty that is helpful to make your decision clear at every time in your life. So it is, he is not talking about the excessive beauty. He is talking about the beauty that is lies inside you and help you to make clear decision regarding your future and career. Understood? I think you understand better. Now I resume the poem ahead. The poet looks within himself. Within himself means he starts watching inside himself and finds that there is hatred inside. Why the war held? Because we are hatred. We have hatred inside our heart for others. So the war took place. He thinks that hatred kills innocence, and wishes that his daughter should not harbor hatred. Whether he has hatred for other people, but he wants his bird, his child, that she should not keep hatred for others. Always she should have love for others and resume her journey in the same way to protect herself in her life. I think you understand it, and now I resume the same thing ahead. It was because of her unwholesome bent of the mind that Maud Gonne married a fool. Once a very beautiful queen or princess, Maud Gonne married a fool. Okay, the poet wishes that her daughter should not cultivate a frantic intellect. He thinks that her daughter can remain innocent if she is free from hatred and intellectual fanaticism. Intellectual fanaticism means spiritual fanaticism. Spiritual and intellectual means who has the knowledge of mythology. If you have the knowledge of mythology, it means you are going through the mythology. It means you are intellectual person. In this way, you have to take care of yourself. And the poet last wishes is that his daughter should marry a person of aristocratic family who may take her to home where tradition and ceremony fill the atmosphere. Means here it means the poet wants her his daughter that she should marry a rich person, aristocrat person to who take her to the traditional ceremony to fill the whole atmosphere for her luxuries and comfort full life. In the end, the poem is a prayer for order and grace in a battered civilization behind the prayer of curse or its bitter memories of Maud Gonne, who had come to stand for the tragedy of how innocent in the end Maud Gonne suffers so a lot due to her decision that she has taken. She married a fool and became very gloom due to the her decision. She made her life very critical and very poor because she decided to marry a fool person. So a man should be intellectual and very strong in decision to take any notice of her life. In this way, in this poem, I would like to remind you once that everything is possible, but a man should take or make his own decision at the right time for the right situation to protect their future. In this way, the same things happens in the mind of the W.B. Yeats, and he was very worried about the future of his daughter, and to protect her, to explain her or to shape and frame her career, he was very worried, and he do so, and he take every step to protect her life, and he became able to do so, and he does not want to repeat the same things that had happened to Maud Gonne, the princess who had taken decision to marry a fool and became means her life became very poor and disgusting, and that's lead her life very problematic. So he is very aware of that, and he does not want to repeat the same thing for her daughter. Thanks for the day, and I think you will enjoy the poem when you have your time to see the video. Please comment and go through the poem, listen me carefully. If you have any problem queries, please put in comment box and listen to the video and see it and enjoy it. Thank you for the day. Have a nice day. Good night to my dear students, and I hope you will enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you for the day.